is Krista Baldwin. I'm a top fuel driver. I'm packing my parachutes, doing the laundry, as they say. You know what this weekend is? It's the U.S. Nationals, the big goat, the granddaddy of them all. Are we gonna go fast tonight? Yes, we are. It's time to warm up.
Should be this one.
Baldwin, 381.7, a career best run made in Brainerd, Minnesota. The conditions are better here. She may and likely will try to dip into the 70s here.
Up by the center line, saw a little pop down there at the finish line. Krista Baldwin goes 386 at 305. Palmer goes 397.
Well, last night, under the lights, you used a clear visor. Tonight, under the sun,
tonight, like,
under the sun?
Well, today.
It's
not night. It feels like it's night already. It's been a long day.
What do you have to say about last night?
One, super great job to my team. They definitely killed it.
Cylinder out for Krista and shuts off. Lex June is chewing one up at the top end, goes 414 at 286 miles an hour. Lex's car got cleanly off the starting line, but again, you saw the cylinders kind of mixing up down there toward the finish line. Krista had one out at about 200 feet, clicked her off. They'll be down to their last session, that's for both of them, to try to get qualified. Well, running 90 won't get you in there. I mean, if you're going to try to run 90, you might as well just stay it in the trailer.
And that's what she said, no point in it. So here we go.
Last shot, not going to happen. 3.901, 318 miles an hour for Lex June. They finally got the car to the finish line, 300 miles an hour, got the chutes out. So they spent an awful lot of effort this weekend, and they're actually high-fiving down there. The fact that they made their best run in the final attempt. Krista goes 393 at 283 miles an hour. And Krista gave it a ride also and came up a little bit short.
So this isn't the sight we wanted to see on Monday morning, but unfortunately, the Composite Specialties Lucas Oil Dragster, we did not make the show for the fastest field in history. A 375 to get in. That would have been awesome, but unfortunately we ran into some gremlins and so we couldn't get the car down the track the way we wanted to. But does that deter us from trying again in a few weeks in Dallas, Texas? No, it does not. And you know what? I am still super grateful to be in the position that I am to drive and own this top fuel car. Let me tell you, I still have so much fun doing all the things, but man, it would have been really cool to get qualified for the U.S. Nationals. But you know what? We'll try it again next year. But until then, thank you guys so much for following along. I completely love all the support of the fans. Until next time, I guess I'll see you guys down in Texas. See you later.